I would like to invite Gösta Gustafson to come up and say a little bit on behalf of the foundation, please.
So Gunnar Kjellén was born in 1926, and he got an exam in as a civil engineer in Gothenburg at Chalmers, but then came after that to Lund to study theoretical physics. And he made a rather rapid career. In 1950, he defended his thesis. That was in the old days with a tough doctor, so he got that in at the age of 24 years. And he became an expert in quantum electrodynamics and continued rapidly, and he was called to a personal professorship here in Lund in theoretical physics in 1958. He rapidly gathered a large group of students around him. I was one of them, and he was a marvelous teacher, so he renewed the course in theoretical physics, teaching himself a new course every semester. And we were working at that time mainly on rather abstract field theory. This was before the modern theories of weak and strong interactions, the Salam-Weinberg model, and before quarks and all that. In 1968, he crashed when he was flying himself towards CERN and killed himself. And his wife was with him, unhurt from the accident, but dying in cancer already. She died about half a year later, and they left four small children behind. People thought that it would be nice to collect some money to give to a fund called Gunnar and Gunnel Kjellén's Memorial Fund to support young students and young physicists, including astronomers, to travel abroad or to invite inspiring guests to Lund. And this is such an occasion. It has often been used for smaller symposia, and the money has been well kept by the Royal Physiographic Society, which means that we are continuing to be able to have this kind of symposium here. So it's nice that we can, I as a student of Kjellén's can remember him in this way, and I hope that you will have a nice day here together.